Game time.
Matt, what are you doing?
I'm actually doing a little bit of research, and I found out that humans can't ink.
I'm sorry. Could you run that by me again?
Some longtime fans might remember that I reviewed Squidlit on the PC. I got it for $3 on Steam, and I really liked it. You can watch that video if you want to hear my in-depth thoughts about it, but overall, it was a fun experience. When I heard that Squidlit was coming to the Switch, I got pretty hyped. The game was only $2, and I liked the PC version, so what could go wrong? Well, let's backtrack just a bit. Squidlit came to the Switch on January 14th, 2020. You are a Squidlit named Plip, and you need to overthrow the God Emperor Squidsquat and save the kingdom of Blipston. So, not out of the ordinary, just a normal Tuesday, you know, normal stuff. And you're going to have to get to the God Emperor Squidsquat's castle by doing a heck of a lot of platforming. And there's also some light puzzles every now and again, but for the most part, it's straight up platforming. As you can see, there are borders on the left and right hand side of the screen. These were not present in the original version I played on Steam, but have since been patched in. You can turn them off with a click of the ZR button, as it says right here. While the Dutes and Juice buttons aren't usable, that's a sentence, alright, the Contrast button actually is. Since this is clearly meant to emulate an original Game Boy, I really like this feature a lot. It's not game-changing, I'm so funny, but it's still a nice feature nonetheless. When it comes to the character models, I have to say it's definitely a lot easier to make out what they are on the big screen or as a handheld, especially the enemies. These are made-up creatures, sure, but it's still a lot easier to distinguish them either way. Speaking of handheld, yes, you can play this in docked or handheld mode, and it does support the Pro Controller as well. But back to the enemies, you can defeat them by inking. So ink! Ink as fast as you can, Gelatinous One! This is the only power you have, but does double as the jump button. And as a double jump button, damn it, I'm so funny. I like it because it forces you to make some tough decisions when trying to fight multiple enemies. Your health bar is made up of 3 muffins. Yes, you heard that right. And if you're reading the captions, you read that right. You don't just have 3 tries though. Each hit takes a portion of a muffin, and there are an abundance of muffins throughout each area. And if you die, you're sent back to the beginning of the area, not to the start of the game. The game does an interesting genre shift with one of the bosses, but a problem I had with the PC version comes into play here as well. No health bar for the bosses. It's not going to kill me. Well, okay, technically it will, but point is that it would have been a nice thing to add for this port. This is a direct port of the PC version, and because of that, sadly a glitch that was present in the PC version is here as well. My biggest problem with this game, and one that I think is a huge flaw, is the lack of a save feature. Now this game is really short, as it will only take you around an hour to beat, but that doesn't change the fact that this is being released on a major platform. Not knocking PC gamers here, but you have to be tethered to your PC while playing, so playing for an hour or so doesn't bother me, but the Switch is marketed as a handheld console. You want to take it on the go, and you definitely don't want to lose progress if you go from playing this on your lunch break to playing it at home. But I don't want to end this on a sour note, so I'd like to take the time to talk about the humor in the game. I absolutely adore it. It really adds on to the cute aesthetic, and it makes me happy to be playing the game again. I know it's not for everyone, but it's definitely for me. Heck, look at this! You can actually do cute little greetings with different Squidlets. This game is adorable! This game was made by a 2-person team, and thinking of it that way, this game really is impressive. I just wish it had more features on the Switch. So sadly, I can't recommend it on this platform. It's definitely worth the $2, but not being able to save is a huge bummer. I give this game 2.5 out of 5 Squidlets living in a hole.
Do you remember when we took a look at Squidlit on the PC and I said, I'm trying to ink? Well, after doing months of research, I found out that humans can't ink.
Oh my God. You really are stupid